His Excellency Mr. Fuadesek. Welcome to Radio Miraya in Juba.
Thank you for having me.
Now, let us speak about the purpose of the visit of the Sanctions Committee to South Sudan this time. This is not the first time you visited the country, but all the same, you can also update us. Why are you visiting Juba at this time?
Senegal took up this job, this position, last January. So I owed it to myself to come and visit and assess for myself. In addition to relying on different reports, including reports produced by the panel of experts that is helping this committee analyze and understand better. We are here just to assess the state of implementations of Resolution 2206 that had been adopted when Senegal was not yet member of the Security Council.
Yeah, yeah.
But yeah. As we have the responsibility of this committee, we have to discharge our function.
The meetings you have held here in the country, in South Sudan, you probably met every, I went through the list, you met every stakeholder in regard to the situation in the country and also in regard to the sanctions. Maybe you can give me an idea what has happened in these meetings.
I want to feel how the South Sudanese people in general view the sanctions and what impact those sanctions have had or have not had to date. Many of them are calling for not only abandoning this sanction, but not even considering new sanction because they will not work. And some argue that more so the region, the regional neighbors of the South Sudan have met recently. They don't want the sanction. If neighboring countries don't cooperate, sanctions really might be ineffective.
You met civil society, because civil society here are quite coming up, speaking about the issues of peace and issues of conflict. And what is your impression?
It was a very, very enriching exchange, because like I said to all of them, we are also here to contextualize the sanctions. If they're working, if they're not working, if they're relevant, if they're not relevant. My last interview when we came out of president's office is the message, the address yesterday, opening up to everybody to silence gun and come and discuss is food for thought for everybody.
Regarding what the president announced yesterday, initiating a national dialogue, and then when you say national dialogue will be going on this way, and then the sanctions will be going on this way, how do the two work together now?
This national dialogue launch is was awaited for by everybody, even the faith-based organization, church leaders and Islamic Council. They were telling there is need for national dialogue, and you committee and the whole union must give peace a chance. We heard the message. We will be reporting to the Security Council, and we see what will be decided.